new at this. He's new to government. And so he probably wasn't steeped in the long-running protocols that established the relationships between DOJ, FBI, and White Houses. He's just new to this.
House Speaker Paul Ryan offering his take on accusations that President Trump asked former FBI Director James Comey to back off the Flynn investigation. Will that fly? The panel is back with me now. So this is the argument, David. President Trump didn't know any different. He's new to this. Does that fly?
Yeah, Brianna, that's not the argument. That was one explanation from one person.
We also heard it from Senator Collins. You have Republicans who are more than one who are saying this.
So that's some people's explanation. You know, what I don't believe is an explanation from Director Comey when asked why he didn't, if he was so uncomfortable, if he felt so awkward, if it was so inappropriate what the president did on 9 times, why did he didn't address the president? Why didn't he say directly to the president, this is an inappropriate conversation we can't have? Instead, he scampered outside to his SUV, scribbled down in a moleskin some private notes to keep later in case of emergency, break glass, and then leak those to a Columbia professor once he lost his job.
The president's not some kid in some internship as president of the United States that doesn't know what he's doing. He sold himself as, I know how to get this job done to the American people. He knew exactly what he was doing. A, he asked his son-in-law to leave the room. He asked the attorney general to leave the room. And he asked the vice president to leave the room. That sounds like somebody who knew exactly what he was doing because he didn't want any witnesses when he went and spoke to the director.
Can I say something?
I know a con artist when I see him.
Have you never
and
done
I saw a I con
take,
artist
I
that
take
day.
Umbrage. That's completely somebody, inappropriate.
No, that's
completely
not inappropriate. This is a president of the United States that went to the FBI director and said to the FBI and went to the FBI director and said to him, end an investigation. And then we're supposed to believe he really doesn't know
Have you ever asked, in a room with your constituents, ask your staff, hey, just hang back here, constituent, I want to talk to you. Have you ever asked that?
I didn't come to
the
program.
It's a simple question.
I don't know that's question. Apples to apples.
Can I just say here, you've mentioned the leaking. First of all, plenty of courts, just to answer your question, plenty of courts have said things like when you ask everyone to leave and hold someone back, is actually a determination of motive. So just to answer that question, that for a court of law usually does show motive. Number two, the whole issue of leaking. I look at what Director Comey did in this situation as whistleblowing, because what happened with the president is on Friday, you can laugh, but what happened with the president is on a Friday, he said there were tapes. He said there were tapes of the conversation, or there may be tapes of the conversation. And that is when Director Comey decided to say, okay, I need to get an alternative set of reality here, which are the actual facts.
On
which
nine
is a memo. Whistleblowing.
I'm new here, an excuse, a way to explain, I didn't know what I was doing, it's not nefarious, when you're talking about several meetings and phone calls?
No, it's not. And what the special prosecutor will have to do is take the totality of all of it. This one testimony, in my mind as a former FBI investigator, does not rise to the level of obstruction of justice. But that's why you have a special prosecutor. They'll go all the way around it. Do the 9 meetings, does it give it weight? I think the worst problem this president has in this instance is the president himself. If he would stop talking about the small ball individual tweets attacking Director Comey personally, I think we could get beyond this. I think the special investigator is going to have some room to investigate.
The president of the United States, under oath, he said 100% he's ready, and I think we can settle this.
He said in his interview with Lester Holt, he gave the reason why he was fired. He said, I fired him because I had the Russia investigation in my mind. So you're right. I say look at the totality and look at the president's own words in the Lester Holt interview, and it tells you why he did it.
David Urban, final word to you. Let's go back to
what Director Comey did. Don't take my word. The assistant director of the FBI of the criminal division was on this show, not this show, but on this network last week saying, what the director did was inappropriate. After that first meeting, when don't roll your eyes, go back and watch the tape. He said it was inappropriate. If he was a part of this investigation, he should have recused himself. He was a material witness, a fact witness, would have been part of it. He should have walked across the street, handed it off. He could have gone to the Hill. Could have gone to Congressman Gutierrez, Senator Feinstein. Plenty of people he could have gone to.
He gave instead, his reason for this because he tried.
He could have done it.
He tried to do the investigation.
Under no, he could have done it. He didn't.
And under then, oath, then, give then his my explanation of what happened.
And my friends,
clear, then the president would have impeded the investigation through getting out
of court of opinion. Yeah. Is not a conviction in the court of law. Very, very two different things.
Final word from the chairman. Thank you so much, Congressman David.